Okay, guys, here's the deal. We gotta have a little chatty chat. A chatteroo.
Alyssa got us coffee. She's comfy.
You should get your coffee and get your comfy.
There's been a large and growing problem that we've seen on YouTube. Clickbait seems to be taking over. We kind of feel like the pot of water is boiling slowly. We don't have to tell you that everybody is using clickbait now. And we also don't have to tell you that they're using it because it works. So we just want to talk about this a little bit today because we have started using clickbait in a lot of our videos. And we hate to say it, but it works for our channel too, and it does help us get more views. On the other hand, you guys don't like this because oftentimes it is deceiving.
So it's funny, I'm actually sitting here editing this video, and Alyssa sends me this screenshot of a comment from Mr. Rick Boatridge. I'd like to call you out, Mr. Rick Boatridge. You say clickbait videos are the bane of YouTube. I cannot stand them. Saying these things saved your life. And then saying, almost run out of logs. What a load of cobblers. I was enjoying your channel and had been quite happily watching a load of videos this past week, but I'm done. No more. Removing you from the lost and viewing channels. I will do the same for anybody who uses clickbait. Good luck in your venture, but you lost me. I find that hilarious, Mr. Rick Boatridge, because I would love to look at your viewer history. And I'll bet if you give me a couple of minutes, I'm going to find more clickbait. You know how I know? You clicked on this video title. Awesome! Firewood alternative that saved our life! We actually did that on purpose, Mr. Rick Boatridge, to try to get people to click on our video, because who wants to listen to somebody talk about firewood? Nobody cares about firewood. But guess what? On YouTube, a video title like Awesome Firewood Alternative That Saved Our Life gets people like you to click on our videos.
And we don't like it either because we feel like we have to resort to like tricking people into watching our videos. We really want to address that today because the problem isn't clickbait, it's a lot deeper than that. What you might not know is that a lot of creators are entertaining the idea of shutting down YouTube altogether because it's just not worth it anymore.
We're taking time out of our day and trying to help the community and creators. And we want to encourage creators out there who see this video to make a response video. There's so much to cover here that there's no way Alyssa and I could possibly hit on all the points. But we also know that we're going to hit you with some bombs today that are going to open your mind. First, I just want to be clear here. We're going to talk about the community first. Second of all, we actually want to address fellow creators because there's some things going on with your channel that you might know about and you might not. And then finally, we want to leave this video on a very positive note. We want to show the community and also creators things that you can do to try to help us to save YouTube. Are we being dramatic here? No. The largest YouTubers in the world have already been cranking out videos on these subjects, but they're channels that not everybody watches.
So briefly, let's touch on how you think YouTube works and how YouTube actually works. You think that you have discretion over which videos are shown to you based on who you subscribe to, right? I believe back in the olden days, all your subscribers' videos would pop up on your homepage of YouTube, and that's actually not the case anymore. I just jumped over to my homepage to see what was showing. There are videos from some people that we subscribe to, but for the most part, more than 50% of the videos are things that we're not subscribed to at all. Here's where YouTube thinks you're an idiot. You think you subscribe to our channel because you want to watch a video on our modest and affordable underground off-grid water system. And YouTube doesn't think you're going to watch it, even though you subscribe to our channel. Next to it is a video you won't believe how he caught his wife cheating on him. And to make matters worse, there's only a handful of videos promoted at any given time, and everyone's competing for those clicks. And if your video doesn't do well, YouTube nixes it. So if there's clickbait in the lineup, we're competing with that. So we have to make a title that's even better just to get views from our subscribers.
Let's see here. Just finished watching a really great video. Let's see, I could watch Wrangler Star, or maybe over here, Starry Hilder, or maybe Falchomatic. Wait, what's this right here? Rocket Stove from Etsy? Well, that doesn't look like a rocket stove at all. Well, maybe I should watch Wrangler Star, Starry Hilder, Falchomatic. Nah, I'm going to watch this one over here about rocket stoves, clearly.
You have to understand that we, as YouTube people and videographers, we work extremely hard on getting our camera gear quality, setting the scene, lighting, sound, distractions, storylines. But stick with me here. None of that matters.
No.
None of it. If you click on a video 17 ways to remove zits from your dog's feathers. Do you understand? Like, that video, if you know what I'm talking about, those videos are almost always pure garbage. The average video from a quality YouTube channel can take 4 to 14 hours to create. That's just the editing. That doesn't involve the shooting, the story, the camera gear, everything. But it does not matter if you don't click on the video. That's why clickbait works, because I can put a video together in about 30 minutes and it can get 17 million views from a bunch of disinterested people who think, that was stupid. Why did I watch that? Because YouTube doesn't care what you watch. All they care is that you watch. YouTube is not a human being. It's an algorithm. So the reason YouTube promotes clickbait is because people watch clickbait. If people stopped watching clickbait, it would die and quality programming would survive. That's not what's happening. It gets deeper than that. We're going to talk about that more in a second. That's the first and foremost problem, is that the only reason clickbait is out there and it's growing is because that's what people click on. That means that a video that took us 30 hours to produce will not get watched over a 2-minute garbage video because our thumbnail and the description don't make you want to click over some other garbage video.
We have an app on our phone that we check like every morning just to see how things are doing. Creators, listen up, because you might not know this, but the first 48 hours the video is launched are extremely critical. If the video gets a lot of views within the first 48 hours, then YouTube will forevermore promote your video, and you've seen it. You have a video that you launch it and it does okay, and then like boom, the video blows up and you're like, what happened? I wouldn't even predicted that that video would blow up. And then other videos, if they don't do well, the first 48 hours, it just disappears forever. And you're like, what the heck? That's a good video. I put my heart and soul into this video. And you're having like moments of self-doubt, thinking that, man, people just hate me. People hate my channel. And that's probably not actually true. So back to the clickbait thing, if there's only 10 videos promoted, if there's a video in that lineup that has more clickbait than what you have, and it has some crazy featured image, your video is never gonna get watched, and it has nothing to do with the quality of your video.
This subject gets really deep. Not that long ago in YouTube world, when you subscribed to a channel, YouTube regularly told you when a new video was published, because they thought, well, hey, you subscribe to the channel, you'd probably wanna know, right? That's changed. YouTube now thinks that you're a knucklehead, in that you, even though you subscribe to a channel, you probably don't want to know when they publish new videos. What you don't know is that YouTube secretly, in the cloak of night, made it so that you, as a community member, you have to jump through a bunch of hoops to even get notified of a new video. Even your subscribers are not seeing your new videos. Think about that for just a second. So you might think to yourself, wow, that channel has 500,000 subscribers or 1 million subscribers. But if you go look at the views on their videos, it's not very good. Maybe 20,000 views, maybe 50 or 100,000. Why aren't those videos getting 500,000 views if they have 500,000 subscribers? You might think, well, the video probably wasn't very good. Wrong. This is YouTube sabotaging the community and creators. There's a lot more to the story, but I just want to be really clear here. If you're a community member and you actually want to get notifications of the channels that you subscribe to, you have to do more than subscribe. We're going to tell you a little bit more later in the video about what you need to do. Why is this important? Because you publish a video and you think, well, maybe my subscribers just didn't like it or something, or maybe the topic wasn't spot on or something. That's not the case. The truth is, your subscribers have no idea you published a video. When they land on YouTube, YouTube's not even telling them that you published a new video. Instead, YouTube is promoting clickbait. I had to test this because I see so many channels doing it that I said, Alyssa, can I just change 10 videos on our channel from a common sense practical video title
and
to something
like, no.
Oh yeah,
no.
Alyssa's like, don't do that.
I'm like, just there like,
I said, who cares? Nobody's watching the video anyway. Nobody cares. It doesn't matter. It's fallen into the abyss of video death. And I said, just let me change the video titles to something so stupid there's no way anybody would click on it. And she's like, fine, if it works, fine. And guess what? It will make you angry that those videos started getting promoted again. and people start watching it. We're establishing beyond the shadow of a doubt that clickbait works. It works on our channel, which is not something that we like. That's why we're making this video. So why does any of this even matter? Well, the reality is that creators are being threatened. As creators, we do need to be compensated for our work. YouTube for the viewers is free, which is fantastic. We actually want it that way. We don't believe that our viewers should have to pay to watch our videos. Why do we feel that way? That does not mean that we don't feel like we should be compensated for our work. YouTube makes a killing off of its creators. And if you're under any delusion that YouTubers are getting rich, you need to adjust your understanding of YouTube. Here's the problem. YouTube hasn't lost a penny in this whole process, but your favorite creators are starting to feel the pinch. And this is why you're starting to see your favorite channels use more and more clickbait. But I want to be clear, it doesn't come down to the YouTube creators being greedy. We need to be compensated, because if we're not getting compensated, I know it sounds crazy, but we don't do YouTube because we're just charity. We have a YouTube channel because it both helps other people and it also helps our family. And all we ask is that we be fairly compensated for our work. If we were trying to get filthy, rotten rich, a YouTube channel is not the way to do it. So what's happening with YouTube is that channels that in the past whose subscribers were getting their videos promoted to them were getting all the views to which they were reasonably entitled. So a channel published a video, you were notified, you watched the video. And it's a win-win symbiotic relationship between the channel and their viewers. The problem is YouTube continues to make it harder and harder and harder for channels to get their subscribers to come back and watch their videos. So a channel that has 500,000 subscribers means nothing. Your subscriber base on YouTube means nothing. How do we know that? There are channels out there that have 1,000 subscribers, which in YouTube world is a drop in the bucket, but they use nothing but clickbait. And those videos might get 2, 10, 20 million views, but they only have 1,000 subscribers. Well, that doesn't make any sense, does it? It's because YouTube doesn't give a crap about subscribers. All it cares about is views. So if you have no subscribers, but you create videos that are clickbait and get people to watch them, you get promoted. On the other hand, if a YouTube channel works really hard to earn people's subscribes and build a relationship, trust, and benefit from each other, sorry, we don't care. YouTube doesn't care. We'd rather just have these guys watching some junk videos over here, because ultimately our advertisers get the same amount of airtime, but we don't really care who gets the views. That's starting to affect channels who in the past published a video and the videos did pretty well because their subscribers were notified and subscribers said, hey, I want to watch more of your videos. Then they started to put the pinch on YouTube channels without telling them. So the consequence is two things. One, the channel's views start to drop. And so it makes a channel think, gosh, what are we doing differently that we weren't doing before? So they first, the channel starts to work harder. They try producing more videos. That's a very common reaction. They think, gosh, maybe we're just not producing enough videos. So they start making more videos. Well, that has a equal and opposite effect on the quality of the videos. Typically, the more you make, the lower the quality. So the quality starts to drop. So the people who are watching your videos go, this channel's not what it once was. I don't want to watch their videos anymore, which has an additional negative effect on the channel. So now they're losing watchers, not subscribers necessarily, but watchers, because their quality is starting to drop. So now you're producing more videos that are lower quality and you're working harder. And now you're starting to get tired. But guess what hasn't happened? Your views haven't gone up, neither have your subscribers. In fact, it may be going down. So now you start to freak out and you start digging and saying, this isn't fun. What happened to my YouTube channel? I used to love YouTube. My subscribers loved me. I loved it. It was fun. We got to have a great time together. This was awesome. And now the channel's starting to starve. So now they start to find out the truth about what YouTube's doing, and they start to find out about clickbait. Out of desperation, they start doing it. They start creating lower quality, more frequent videos, and they use clickbait to get the watches. Then their subscribers, who were still watching them, get mad because they're now mad that your channel's using clickbait. They're like, why do they gotta use clickbait? I hate clickbait. Clickbait's stupid. Even though their videos really are about the same as they were before-ish. As a way of boycotting and sending a loud and clear message to the channel, the YouTubers start unsubscribing. Like, we're going to show this channel. You can't get clickbait past me. But the funny thing is, those same jerks are the ones clicking on clickbait. Yeah. You're the jerk who's making YouTube promote clickbait over your favorite channels. And then, because you have some sort of trust and relationship with this channel, you punish them for using clickbait. Do you see the irony? Then the channel really starts to suffer. So now they've lost all the people who are offended by lower quality, more frequent videos. Then they've lost the people who think, I know you and trust you. I'm mad that you're using clickbait. So now the channel really starts to go down the toilet. And you start to see channels doing crazy things to try to get views because they're mad. They're mad that their channel has fallen all apart and they don't know why. When you watch an absolutely garbage six bikini styles you'll never believe for summer, you don't even know the channel. So you don't take time out of your day to comment,
hey, clickbait. Clickbait sucks.
You only do that on channels that you know, like, and trust.
Yep.
So you punish us because you feel like you know us and you're like, oh, I don't like it when people I know use clickbait. But yet you click on some random channel that has no subscribers and you don't even take the time out of your day to comment on their channel because you don't care about them.
You see people all over the place getting things like Patreon. They're getting these accounts that they're now hoping that people that love their content are willing to pay them or donate a certain amount per month or a certain amount per video. But like, if all my subscribers just gave me $1 a month because they genuinely love our content and look forward to it, that would make this worth it for us. But we feel, we're not saying we'll never get something like that one day if people choose to support us in that method, but for now we've been holding off because we really feel that advertisers are paying so much money to be on our videos. And don't get us wrong, there is benefit to having the videos on YouTube. There's a lot that we're able to take advantage of for the community. A lot of creators probably should be getting a little bit more of a cut that they're actually getting, and they shouldn't be having to ask our subscribers for additional money to fund their YouTube account.
I want to be really clear here. You should not have to pay to watch YouTube. The reason YouTube even exists is because creators create content for you to watch. So everybody wins. You get videos to watch, we create videos for you to watch, and YouTube has a platform to sell their advertising. Awesome possum. Yeah. But here's the problem. You get all the stuff to watch, creators get a ridiculously small amount of the revenue share, and Google starts making self-driving cars.
We don't think Google shouldn't make money. They should.
We're not opposed to Google making a profit. That's not what we're saying here.
We're just saying that because of this whole situation, they're about to lose some of their top creators.
We're sharing this with you as a community because not because Pure Living for Life is necessarily going away. A lot of your favorite creators are thinking about it. First of all, let's just establish, how do we even know that Google's making a killing? Well, it just so happens that YouTube's not the only way in the world to make money with video. So we actually do video on multiple platforms. And we have other companies who pay us 8 times as much money
plus
as Google. Yep. 8 times.
And what's hard is these people that are paying us 8 times more,
they're making a profit.
So it's a lot more of a win-win. And some of these other ad companies that we partner with on our blog, not our YouTube channel, they work with us to help us grow our blog and produce good content, because when we produce good content, you as the viewer win, we win, and they win. Like, win, win, win. That's the best kind of relationships there are.
So what we're saying is you shouldn't have to pay to watch YouTube. Now, if you want to support your channel, your favorite channels,
yeah, nothing wrong with
please,
that either.
We're not at all saying don't get a Patreon account. We're not saying don't solicit people if they want to support you, because that's awesome. If people, that's how people want to support you, then let them. You shouldn't have to be paying to watch advertising. They are making a killing off of your airtime.
I think at this point, this video might start to sound like we're just beating on and hating on YouTube. We all love YouTube. That's why we're on it. That's why we create videos. That's why we share them. That's why our subscribers come there.
We're also not being negative. We're not complaining. We're passionate.
The other companies that we work with who help us monetize some of the work that we do. Let me back up. If you're watching this video and you think we shouldn't be paid for our work, please stop watching this video. And then I want you to write a letter to me explaining to me how you get paid for your job, but you think we shouldn't be compensated. The other platforms that we use that help us monetize our work with us. They help us. They're always trying to find ways to help everybody, because when we create good stuff, they benefit, you benefit, everybody benefits. YouTube does not care at all. 0%. They're not, they secretly in the cloak of night change how their website works, the way you think it works, the way we think it works, and they don't tell a soul until you start to realize, how come I don't get any of these videos from these channels I subscribe? Then you're like, well, that doesn't make any sense. YouTube doesn't tell you. They don't care. They don't even tell us. The people who have made YouTube what it is have no idea. Not even the biggest YouTubers in the world even get a little bit of an email from anybody that's like, hey, just so you know, we changed the algorithm. Clickbait is here to stay. And the only person who has the control to change that is you, the community. So if you don't do anything, if you do nothing and you continue the way everything is now, YouTube and clickbait are going to be here forever. It's not going anywhere because right now it's working and that's what YouTube wants. If you think that unsubscribing and stopping watching your favorite channels is helping, you're actually ruining those channels because they're hanging on by a thread, a lot of them. I'm not necessarily talking about us. I'm talking about the channels who have invested 5, 8, 10 years of their lives into creating resources and videos for people to watch, be entertained and educated. Those channels are getting shoved in the corner and they're borderline thinking about doing something else. So if you care about those channels at all, understand that they're using clickbait because they have to. They're trying to keep their channel alive. If you have a channel that you absolutely love, 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 we're going to jump into a few things that you can do both as community and as creators that we can do together to help keep YouTube a good place for us to continue creating videos.
The first thing you could do is subscribe to get notifications for the channels that you actually care about. Because remember, just because you're subscribed doesn't mean you're being notified of their new videos. So we just unsubscribe from Vouchamatic just for fun, and I'm gonna walk you through how to get notifications on their channel. You're already subscribed, so you won't have to hit the subscribe button. Then you see that little bell? Click on the bell. Notifications. Send me all notifications for this channel. And then, right here, you'll see how you're notified. Push and email. Email, pretty straightforward. Email notifications. Push notifications are to your phone. We actually watch most of our YouTube from our phone, so it's nice to see that a channel we watch has a new video, so that's really helpful. If it only says email, what you're gonna click is manage settings. And under channel subscriptions. Okay, right here. Make sure this is checked. Occasionally notify me of new videos and activity from my subscriptions. I believe by default this is unchecked. It's only checked because we checked it. And then here, subscriptions notify me via push and email. Of course, if you don't want both of those, don't check it, but we suggest that you do because even then, we still don't find that we get 100% of videos, but it's a place to start.
I'll bet you thought that was enough, and you'd be wrong. So, if you sign up for push notifications on YouTube, they're still not going to send them to you. If you have an iPhone or some other kind of smartphone, it's very likely you'll have to go to the notifications area, find the app, because it's an app notification, mind you. So if you don't even have the app, you're still not gonna get notifications. You're gonna have to download their stupid app. Then you have to go to notifications and turn them on. Oh, here, YouTube. I have allow notifications off. So if I don't have this on, I'm still not gonna get notified, even though you think you said notify me. You didn't, because this is not on. For you creators out there, you're already catching on, but we just want to restate this. You're going to have to inform your subscribers of this. YouTube isn't telling anybody, you or us included. So if you want your subscribers to get notifications about your new videos, which we assume you do, you're going to have to find a way to inform them. And it's not going to be easy because YouTube's not telling them you're making videos. So you need to find a way to get people to take those additional steps so that your videos can be watched. So this brings us kind of to the next point about what subscribers can do to support channels that they love. And it's really simple. Watch their videos. The YouTube algorithm pays a lot of attention to how subscribers interact with your videos because YouTube uses that as a pulse to check whether a video is good or not. Therefore, if you like a channel and you watch that video in the first 48 hours after it's live, YouTube makes a determination based on that whether to promote that video to people who are subscribed to the channel and not subscribed to the channel. Therefore, if you choose not to watch videos that your channel produces, that whole entire channel, not the video, the channel gets demoted and their videos slowly lose traction on YouTube. Not just to non-subscribers, but also to other people who maybe haven't seen the video yet, but come to YouTube maybe 3, 4, or 5 days later, they're not going to see the videos either. Put simply, the best way to support your favorite YouTube channels is to watch their videos within 48 hours of them being published. That will help the video have the greatest amount of success possible. In case it's still not clear, the number one way you can support your favorite YouTube channel is don't watch garbage clickbait videos.
Don't watch garbage clickbait videos.
That's it, because YouTube's only gonna do what works. And if you keep watching those videos, then you can't be mad when all the quality creators leave. For you creators out there, if you're creating quality content, listen to your audience. If your channel's growing and your audience is on board and behind you, then don't disrespect them. Don't keep shoving garbage in their face because you're willing to sacrifice a few subscribers to grow your channel. Your loyal subscribers will thank you and they'll stay loyal to you. YouTube's probably gonna always go through cycles like this. If you're out there creating low quality garbage videos and you're gonna continue to use stupid, immature, juvenile clickbait, then don't be mad when your subscribers start to abandon you.
Outside of YouTube, there's a few other things you can do to support your favorite creators, or if you're a creator yourself, where you can disperse your media. We have active pages on Facebook, Instagram, and even Pinterest. And through these platforms, we can let people know when we have a new video. So if you follow us on multiple platforms, there's a really good chance, or let's just say the odds will be increased, that you'll know when we have a new video out. The other thing you could do is follow that person's personal email list, not through Facebook, not through Pinterest, not through YouTube, their own email list. The thing with that is that email platforms have their own little workarounds that you need to work around. So if you're subscribed to someone's email list, you'll want to be sure to add their email to your contacts. Otherwise, Gmail especially will send it straight to the spam or the promotional folder. And it's not really promotional. Most of these people like us, we're not trying to sell anything. We're just trying to let you know, hey guys, we have a new video out. We think you might like it because you subscribed to our list.
So to be clear, Gmail takes an email that you subscribe to and puts it in your spam folder because it assumes
it's spam,
like all the other Viagra, get all your prescription medications for free emails. So if you don't want Gmail thinking for you, you don't want Gmail to think, you probably don't want to read that email, then you have to tell Gmail, I want these emails in my inbox. I don't want them in my promotions tab. I don't want them in my spam. I want to read them. You subscribe to the email. So if you want it, you have to tell Gmail, I want this email. Otherwise, it's going to just throw it away.
If you're a creator, stop getting in bed with one channel. Channels disappear overnight. I'm not saying that'll happen to YouTube, but there's a seasonality with these things. So if you get married or get in bed with one platform, when that platform starts to decline, you can't be upset that you can't get in contact with this following you've been building for the past 5 or 10 years. Email lists are great because email probably isn't going anywhere for a very long time, and that's one reliable way to let people know about what's going on in your life.
The point here is for those creators out there, you own your content, mm-hmm. and you are responsible for your future. You can't blame YouTube if you choose to rely on them heavily for all the things that they do and your channel starts to suffer, which is happening to a lot of channels. Yep. You can't be mad because you didn't think far enough ahead to keep your people your people. We love our people and we think our people love us. So we want to make sure that if YouTube goes the,
you know, it's my ear hug, guys, my ear hug.
So if YouTube starts to sink, we believe that our subscribers still want to hear from us. So we've taken the additional steps to make sure that they can do that outside of mm-hmm. YouTube. Another way we like to support channels that we love without spending any money or contributing money directly to the channel is a lot of channels have an affiliate link, probably through Amazon, but sometimes they're through other websites. And if you shop online at all, if you make a purchase through their link, so you click on their link and go to somewhere like Amazon, and then you make a purchase, that channel will receive a small commission when you make that purchase. It doesn't cost you anything, and it doesn't cost the channel anything. But that advertiser or that company will pay that channel a small commission. So for example, when we buy camera gear, we pick one of the channels that we really, really love. We click on their affiliate link and we purchase our camera gear. It doesn't cost us anything extra, but that channel will get a little kickback from our purchase. Some channels are more conspicuous about this than other channels. But if you have a channel that you really, really love and you don't see any clear way to support them, don't hesitate to ask, is there a simple thing I could do to just support you? A lot of times there is a way, but most creators don't want to sit around and sweat the money side. They want to spend their time creating. So if a channel does have something like a patron and you want to contribute to that, go for it. But if you don't see something, don't be afraid to reach out to that channel and just ask.
Are you guys feeling better at all? I know sometimes we go into these chats like we're not really sure what to expect, but at the end you're like, you know what? I really like you. Like, I'm vibing. Like, I'm feeling this. I'm motivated. I feel like we have a really good relationship. And that's what we're trying to do with you guys in the YouTube community. We really want there to be this great relationship between creators and viewers. We don't want there to be guilt for people trying to succeed. I think at the end of the day, everyone on YouTube, they really are, most of them, trying to create really high quality videos. They're trying to listen to their subscribers, trying to give people what they want, trying to make videos great, entertaining, all that good stuff. We just feel that there's been some issues that have been needing addressed, and we feel like if everyone has a better understanding of this issue, and we aren't attacking each other, but we're working together to resolve the situation, that would just make the world go round, right? Or is that too optimistic? Like,
I'm getting a little teary-eyed over okay. here. This video is somewhat of a warning, as much as it is an outreach.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you've watched your favorite TV show and then one day you found out it got canceled.
Dexter.
And it got, but that's not even the bad part. Like, it makes you a little sad. But what makes you really sad is that what's getting promoted is The Real Housewives of LA, which everybody knows is pure garbage. So if you don't want YouTube to become that, it's on us to work together. That's why we're creating this video. We're trying to do our part and reach out and inspire both the community and other creators to take action. Otherwise, we're all going to get canceled in favor of low quality smut. So that's why we're making this video, because we hope it will help the community be a little better. We're never going to fix YouTube.
Yep.
That's a YouTube problem. But for those people who watch this video and the creators, maybe we can kind of save our little corner of YouTube and keep it from becoming a low quality poopy snake bit.
All right, we got to wrap this up pronto because we're getting kind of hangry and we're going to leave you guys with some feel goods, okay?